Matt Lenihan Boxing Social in association with Empire Fight Store. Been joined by Michael Conlon. Slick, looking very... looking very tan, mate. You've been hitting the sunbeds?
No. I've been away for the last month in Portugal, so...
You've topped up. Look at the colour of you.
I have no time to top. I'm gone. And I'll do sunbeds above your skin.
All right, whatever. Anyway, tonight, Abbas Barão. Two entertaining fights in a row now that he's had. I thought the right man won tonight. But McCallum McGowan was very game tonight. Tough, tough customer. Just give us your reaction to Abbas getting a victory and defending his European title tonight.
I thought it was a very good fight. I scored a 10-2 myself. He just boxed and didn't let himself get dragged in too much of a war. But you could see he was very comfortable there. He was standing there and letting shots like zing past him with his hands down. And that's when you know he's really just having fun. But I thought it was a good performance, a very clean performance, but credit goes to McCauley because he is a tough, tough man.
Yeah.
Tough man.
You could see that his face were getting marked up as well towards the back end. I felt like Abbas from sort of round 8 onwards almost got like a new lease of life as well and went through the gears a little bit. How good of a fighter in your eyes do you believe he is? You've trained alongside him, obviously. I know he's a good friend, but loyalties aside, do you believe he can become world champion?
I definitely do, yeah. I think that performance is probably only 60% of Abbas, really. Mm-hmm. I've seen him do things in the gym which I don't see much fighters do. His engine is unbelievable. He showed that tonight and against Eggington. Tonight, he didn't need to show as much as what he did against Eggington because he's so aggressive and throws so much punches. But you know, I just thought it was a clean performance, and I do think you know, he's very, very talented.
100%. Look, I know it's late, so we'll just keep this short and sweet. Any update on yourself? I know you've mentioned you're coming back. You started punching again, I believe, on this holiday, this golf trip you've been on.
Yeah.
Where are we at with things? Feeling good to be back at it?
Yeah, mate, very good. I went back, done my first boxing session at the end of May there when I was away, and I done 4 rounds in the bag, and I felt like 12 rounds. I was like, Jesus, it's hard being away. Even though I've been running marathons and stuff.
It's different fitness, though.
Different, it's different. And I've lost at that stage before I went in that camp, holiday, whatever you want to call it. I'd lost every bit of muscle I ever had. It all gone, but I've built myself back up a little bit, and I'm happy to be back. But with me, I'm just now going to trial a few different coaches. Yeah. That'll start from Monday, and then I'll be trying a few more.
100%. Obviously, without devastating the last time was, have you sort of see this as like a completely new chapter? I know the last one was called The Get Back, and you can give it what name you want, Michael Conlon 2.0, 3.0, but you feel like almost now that maybe a bit of weight of expectation is sort of off now. Not that people are doubting you, but you will have people who are, you know, thinking, you know, is it still there? And all these questions. Is it a case of now you're just doing this because you've something to prove to yourself?
That's it. It's only about myself. I don't care what people say, whether they're saying he's amazing or whether they're saying he's shit. It doesn't matter because, you know, my opinion is the only opinion that matters, and I believe I can still go on and still do things and achieve things, which I believe, you know, I've set my goals to do, and, you know, I think I'll do it.
Not to count your pocket, but obviously you seem to be doing well outside of the sport in terms of you've got a promotional company which is on the rise at the minute. Shout out to Conlon Boxing. Obviously, you've got a couple of good shows coming up as well. Good signings as well in Pierce O'Leary, but we'll talk on that another day. So you're doing this purely because you want to do it. There's no financial reason or anything like that. This is a need for you, isn't it?
Yeah, 100%. Listen, financially, I'm okay. I'm not in it just to win money. You know, obviously it's a part of the whole thing, but I'm there to reach my goals, which I believe I can still achieve. So that's it. I'm not coming back. It's not like I'm skinned, I'm laying in the gutter going, I need money. Yeah. I don't, I'm good. I have a lot of things going on in the background, different businesses, different ventures. So, you know, I haven't been silly with the things I've done in boxing and the money I've earned from boxing. So, you know, like a lot of fighters probably do waste a lot of money. I was always very smart in that sense.
We're coming into a new era of the sport now where I think there's less pressure on this whole undefeated record. I think for a bygone year, rightly or wrongly, because the likes of a Floyd Mayweather, you know, marketed himself of having that. But we're seeing fighters now. You look at a Big Bang Zhang, for instance, takes a defeat to Joseph Parker, straight back in there, and got a good win over Deontay Wilder. He'll be back out again, and we're entering into that now. Is that sort of give you that sort of I don't know what it is, whether it's motivation or whatever it is, to say, you know what, you know, fuck it, it's a loss, shit happens kind of thing?
No, because that happened to me 2 years ago. So yeah. I'd lost that 2 years ago, and you realise it doesn't actually matter. No. You can move forward and keep doing what you're doing. So, you know, that's not something that bothers me, no.
Will you be going into this at 126? I know you went up to the last fight at 130, but are you going back down to what is your natural weight?
Yeah, listen, the last fight was said to me, as it was announced 8 weeks out, so I had basically 6 weeks of training. I was happy enough to go to 134 because it was seeing me having to cut the extra route, which in hindsight, you go, maybe you shouldn't have done it, maybe you should have just done 126, but, you know, that's the way it was. So, yeah, back to 126, my natural weight, it can make it handy enough.
Hopefully, back out at the end of the year or early next year, or are you not even putting a thing on it?
Hopefully by the end of the year, yeah. But no fight scheduled, no fight pinned. The date I'm looking at, December, November. But who knows, it could be next year. And the break has been nice, it's been really good. You know, I've been out of the gym, I haven't punched, and actually getting back to punching, my hands are sore, you know what I mean? So because I haven't punched in so long, and like everything just takes time, move it slowly and build back into it. So yeah, towards the end of the year, probably starting next year, who knows?
Fellow countryman Anthony Kakachi went over there and did a great performance over Joe Cordina. Kakachi's career was one where, even though he's not taking like a significant defeat, it was sort of stalling with pullouts and fights that didn't happen, but he got his opportunity and took it. Is that maybe, obviously, just a fellow Irishman, like, give you that bit of, you know, a thing, that inspiration? So, you know, I can still get a world title in this game. You know, with the belts, with Lopez, there's talks of him moving up, fragmenting. There's still some big fights out there for you and an opportunity, providing the right steps are taken.
That's it. You just need to take the right steps. But, yeah, listen, that was delayed for Ando and felt bad for Joe because I'm friends of both.
Yeah.
I actually had Ando over sparring before Lee Wood fight and stuff. So, yeah, like, we're all close in Belfast. We all know each other, so... When he won it, it was delayed for him. He changed his life. You know, he's had a very stop-start career. You know, his pretty earnings haven't been too high, but he's done that. Now he can change his life and set his family up. So I was delighted for him. But, you know, I don't, looking at it, kind of, it did motivate me to go, fuck us, we can still go here. But, you know, I'm not, it's not about that. It's about myself and about the fire inside me and the drive inside me to want to keep going and they want to achieve the stuff I want to achieve. So yeah.
Do you have to become world champion before you knock this on the head? Is that a must? Like, as in, if you get to that point, you win your title, will you then go, I've done it, kind of thing? Is that the one thing that's missing, or is it just the big fights? Will that be enough to satisfy you in the sport?
No, my goal is to be a world champion. Yeah, you know, I really want to achieve that goal. Something I set out from the start of my career was to say that and to do that, and you know, I have all the ability in the world to do it, and I've come up short twice in two world title fights, one by a minute and a half, and you know, look back and go, geez, if I had done this, I had done that, but there's no point to dwelling on the past. It's gone, and you learn things from the ending. So yeah, to be world champion is definitely the aim, and Well, I settle and retire after. Don't know if you win that there, you got bigger fights and bigger money fights to come. So I'd probably stay. Yeah,
I've seen you on a few podcasts. Forgive my ignorance. So there's just been clips that have come through every now and again, and you talked about the things that weren't right before. You touched on them. I know you didn't go into great detail. Is all that put to bed now?
Yeah. Everything's kind of smooth now.
Weight lifted off your shoulders, because you could see. Obviously, no one's going to go, but it was weighing heavy on your life.
Yeah, no, it definitely was. And, you know, I've put a lot of things to bed. I moved on from a lot of things. And now I finally got, you know, a house sorted, because I'd sold my house, the bad house up in the mountain, two years ago, and I fell through. And then my house was gone. I was like, all right, fuck it, I'm going to rent. And I ended up just being stuck renting. Both world title fights. I had to move house because one landlord wanted to sell their house. And then the second one, or the first one, was we sold our house to buy a house, and then it fell through, and then ended up renting. So that was all during the Lee Wood fight. And then the second one, the landlord wanted to sell his house, and he kicked his head. I was like, for fuck's sake, again. So I was like, no, bad woman. But now we've got that sorted. Everything is smooth now. So yeah. I'm on the right path.
Good.
In terms of personal, and you know, sporting wise. career-wise, my head's back. I'm ready to go, and I've still got things to do, so I ain't letting no one stop me.
100%, I think we end it there. Michael Conlon, appreciate you giving us some of your time. Look forward to seeing you back doing your thing and seeing where this journey takes you.
Cheers, mate.